This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Storytelling System, formerly Storyteller System, is a role-playing game system created by White Wolf, Inc. in 1991 that premiered in Vampire, The Masquerade, a part of the World of Darkness series. Contents 1 History 11 Storyteller System 12 Storytelling System 2 Character Creation 21 Attributes 22 Abilities and Skills 23 Advantages 24 Virtues and Vices 25 Supernatural Templates 26 Backgrounds and Merits 27 Experience or Bonus Points 3 Game Mechanics Mechanics 31 Dice Pools 311 Storyteller System Difficulty 312 Storytelling System 3121 Target Numbers 3122 Modifiers 3123 Keeping Time 3124 Actions and Combat 3125 Taking Damage 32 Rewards 33 Variant Systems 34 God Machine Rules 4 Books 5 References History Storyteller System While on the road to Gen Con 90, Mark Rein-Hagen came upon the idea of a new game design that would become Vampire, The Masquerade. Tom Dowd, co-designer for Shadowrun, worked with Rein-Hagen to adapt the core mechanics from his previous game success to use D10 instead of D6 for calculating probability over the next few years. Several games were published under this rule set. Vampire, The Masquerade 1991 Werewolf, The Apocalypse 1992 Mage, The Ascension 1993 Street Fighter, The Storytelling Game 1995 Wraith, The Oblivion 1996 Changeling, The Dreaming 1997 Kindred of the East 1998 Hunter, The Reckoning 1999 Trinity 1999 Exalted 2001 Mummy, The Resurrection 2001 Demon, The Fallen 2002 Orpheus 2003 Vampire, The Masquerade, 20th Anniversary Edition 2011 Werewolf The Apocalypse, 20th Anniversary Edition 2013 Mage, The Ascension, 20th Anniversary Edition 2014 Storytelling System. The Storyteller System was discontinued in 2003 after completing the metaplot building up. Since Vampire, The Masquerade, it was replaced by the Storytelling System, a more streamlined rule set. The Storytelling System premiered in the World of Darkness in 2004, The World of Darkness August 2004 alongside Vampire, The Requiem. Vampire, The Requiem released in August 2004 alongside the main core rulebook Werewolf, The Forsaken March 14, 2005 Mage, The Awakening August 29, 2005 Promethean, The Created August 10, 2006 Changeling, The Lost August 16, 2007 Hunter, The Vigil August 14, 2008 Geist, The Sin Eaters August 2009 Mummy, The Curse September 2012 Demon, The Descent March 2014 Beast, The Primordial forthcoming 2015. Games using variants on this set of rules include Exalted, Scion and the Trinity Line. Character Creation Storytelling System. Characters are built with character points that represent a dot on their character sheets. Each dot represents a 10-sided die D10. The more dots in an attribute or skill, the better the character is at those abilities. A set of dice representing the dots in an attribute or skill forms a dice pool that the character uses to see if he, she succeeds or fails at specific tasks. Attributes. Characters have 9 attributes in 3 groups: mental, physical, and social. In the Storytelling System, attributes are also divided into 3 use-based categories: power, the ability to alter one's environment; finesse, the ability to use power efficiently; and resistance, the ability to cope with power being exercised upon one's self. Storytelling System attributes: mental, physical, social, power, intelligence, strength, presence, finesse, wits, dexterity, manipulation, resilience, resolve, stamina, composure. All attributes begin with 1 dot. Normally, attributes can have up to 5 dots. With 1 dot, a character is poor in that attribute and gets 1 die. With 2 dots, they are average and get 2 dice. 3 dots, they are good. 4 dots, they are exceptional. And with 5 dots, they are outstanding and have 5 dice. Starting characters get a number of dots to add to their attributes. The player must choose primary, secondary, and tertiary attribute categories, getting a large number of dots to assign to primary attributes, a moderate number to assign to secondary attributes, and a small number for tertiary attributes. The first dot of each attribute is free, the second to fourth dots cost 1 dot each, and the fifth dot costs 2 dots to fill in. The primary, secondary, and tertiary designations have no effect after character creation. Abilities and skills. Characters have a wide array of skills. Storytelling or abilities. Storyteller to choose from that represent specialized areas of knowledge. In the storytelling system, skills are divided into mental, physical and social skills. In the storyteller system, abilities are divided into three types: knowledges, talents, and skills like attributes. Each ability, skill has five dots that represent how many dice a skill gets. Characters get a number of dots to fill in the ability, skill dots, and like the attributes, they must assign a specific number of skills to the primary, secondary and tertiary skill groups like attributes. The fifth dot costs two dots to fill in, and the primary, secondary and tertiary distinctions have no effect after character creation. Advantages. Advantages in the game are such things as the character's defense score, health, initiative, morality, size, speed, and willpower. Some derived attributes are as follows. Defense is the negative modifier an opponent gets when he tries to attack a character, which is equal to the number of dots in the lower of dexterity or wits. It is exclusive to the storytelling system. Health is how well the character copes with injury in the storytelling system. Health is equal to stamina size in the storyteller system. Characters almost universally have exactly 7 health levels. Initiative is a measure of the character's reaction time. It is equal to dexterity. Composure, and is exclusive to the storytelling system. Morality is a measure of the character's sense of compassion toward their fellow man, and respect for the law. Morality has a base numerical value of 7, and can change higher or lower throughout the game depending on what the character does. It could rise for doing good things and lower for doing evil. Losing morality can cause characters to gain derangement, and affects the self-control of certain supernatural creatures, such as vampires and werewolves. In the storytelling system, all playable characters have a morality stat whose name changes with the setting. Morality for humans, humanity for vampires, harmony for werewolves, and so in the storyteller system, only vampire. The Masquerade uses a morality system. Size is how big or small a character is. It is a numerical value, and for base humans, size is equal to 5, and is reduced for smaller, and increased for larger-sized creatures. Willpower, a measure of a character's self-confidence and determination, and determines the size of a character's temporary willpower pool. In the storytelling system, it is equal to resolve. Composure, unless it has been temporarily lowered, in which case it can be bought back with experience. In the storyteller system, willpower is rated from 1 to 10, and the method of calculating a character's base willpower rating varies by game line. Virtues and vices. In the storytelling system, each character has one virtue and one vice. A virtue is some defining quality of a character's personality and is one that clearly reflects their basic beliefs. Players chose from the 7 virtues, which include charity, faith, and justice. A vice is a basic weakness in the character's personality. They are the 7 deadly sins, such as envy, lust, and greed. Characters can regain willpower by fulfilling their virtue or vice. In the earlier storyteller system, different sets of virtues are used, and only in a couple games. Vampire, the Masquerade uses them for varying forms of self-control, and Hunter, the Reckoning ties them directly to Hunter's supernatural powers. Supernatural templates. In the storytelling system, playable supernatural characters are created by applying a template to the character during character creation, before merits or experience. For instance, with a vampire character, a template describing certain vampiric attributes, disciplines, blood points, etc. is added to keep the game balanced. Only one supernatural template can be applied per character. Backgrounds and merits. Merits are special beneficial abilities and strengths a character may possess. They are similar in a way to feats in D20 system games, allowing characters to do something the main rules usually don't allow. They are organized in the mental, physical, and social categories like attributes and skills. In the storytelling system, starting characters get 7 dots to purchase merits. Some merits apply to certain attributes and provide a bonus when using them. Some also require a certain number of dots in some other attribute in order to purchase them. Each trait has a certain number of dots associated, which indicate its dot cost. A trait with 4 dots, for example, common sense, costs 4 dots to purchase. Others have a range of dots. Language, for instance, is 1 dot, and a character can buy a certain level of it as they choose. In the storyteller system, merits are optional, are purchased with bonus points, and have costs ranging from 1 to 7 points. In the storyteller system, backgrounds are advantages such as contacts, resources, and status. In the storytelling system, backgrounds have been absorbed into merits. Furthermore, the linguistics knowledge, representing knowledge of specific languages, has also been absorbed. Experience or bonus points. In the storytelling system, more powerful or experienced characters can spend experience points at the end of character creation. Exclusive to the storyteller system, bonus points are used to increase traits at character creation, with more powerful or experienced characters getting additional bonus points at character creation. Game mechanics. All mechanics of the storytelling system utilize a number of 10-sided dice. D10's World of Darkness games suggest players to have at least 10 D10s available to roll for their characters' task resolutions and attribute tests. The game master in a WW game is called the storyteller. Dice pools depending on what the situation calls for. A character has a number of dots in attributes and skills associated to the task. Each dot represents a D10 die that is added to a dice pool to roll for task resolution. For example, if a character is scaling a wall, they add the number of dots in their strength attribute and their athletics skill together. In this case, if the character has a strength of 3 dots, and an athletics skill of 4 dots, they get 7 dice in their dice pool. Storyteller system difficulty. Each die rolling above the target number is a success. Most tasks require only a single success, but some require more. Each die rolling a 1 cancels out a success. If the net number of successes is 0 or less, the action is a failure. If no successes were rolled and one or more ones were also rolled, the action is a botch, resulting in detrimental results to the player's storytelling system. Target numbers. The target number in WoD games is always 8. A D10 dice roll needs to roll 8s, 9s, and 10s to bring up a success. A roll of 7 or less is a failure. As long as one success is rolled, that character has achieved their task. 5 or more successes in a roll is an exceptional success, and usually something very beneficial happens for the character, above what they had expected. Anytime a die comes up as a 10, a player may re-roll it to see if it gets another 8 or higher. This is called 10 again. If the re-roll succeeds, it counts as another success to be added in. Any time a character has absolutely no dice remaining in their pool as a result of negative modifiers, the task would seem impossible to perform. The character is still allowed a single D10 die roll, called a chance roll, to see if sheer blind luck or divine intervention allows them to succeed. Result of 10 as a success can be re-rolled for more successes. See 10 again. Rule above, 2-9 is a failure and a result of 1 is a dramatic failure. Modifiers. Modifiers are either bonuses or penalties to a die roll that are determined and added in by the storyteller. This will subtract or add to the number of dice that can be rolled in a dice pool. The maximum number of dice that can be added or subtracted is 5. Keeping time. Time in storytelling system is measured in small turns of 3 seconds. Turns further make up a scene, which further make up a chapter. A chapter is usually one gaming session, and chapters are linked together into an overall story set in a chronicle or the big picture. The theme and setting of the entire game. Actions and combat. There are 3 basic kinds of actions in a storytelling system. Instant actions take up very little time, like taking a gun off safety, or shouting a small message to an ally. Extended actions take longer time to accomplish and can extend over a number of turns to complete, like getting a stuck window open, or changing a light bulb. Contested actions are actions that involve dealing with what the opposition does, like shooting at a running target during a combat scene. Taking damage for every success a character has on their attack roll against an opponent, they inflict 1 health point of damage upon the target. There are 3 kinds of damage in WW games: bashing, lethal and aggravated. Bashing damage is inflicted by blunt objects that bludgeons targets like a baseball bat. Lethal damage is caused by slashing and piercing weapons like knives and guns. Aggravated damage is inflicted mainly by supernatural sources and the weaknesses of supernatural creatures such as fire and sunlight against vampires or silver against werewolves. However, it can also be inflicted by severe radiation poisoning. Characters recover from bashing damage quickly, while aggravated damage takes the longest to recover from. Health boxes are checked off by damage when the last box is checked with bashing damage. A character is generally at risk of passing out. If the last box is checked with lethal damage, a character is helpless and generally at risk of dying without medical attention, and if the last box is checked with aggravated damage, a character is dead. If a character's health track is filled with bashing damage, any additional bashing damage is upgraded to lethal, and if a character's health track is filled with lethal damage, any additional bashing or lethal damage is upgraded to aggravated. Rewards. After a game, a storyteller can award experience points to players to improve their characters' attributes, talents and skills. Experience distribution is typically based upon role-playing performance, especially if flaws are present, as well as accomplishing short and long-term goals. Variant systems. In the classic WoD, the storyteller dictated a target number, which was a number a player needed to roll at or above on his dice in order to generate a success. The standard target number in the previous WoD systems was 6, with a sliding scale for difficulty. The Exalted, Cyan Trinity systems use a flat target number of 7 for almost all roles. A more dramatic variant is the Mind's Eye Theater System, which is designed for LARP rather than tabletop role-playing God Machine rules. In July 2013, White Wolf released a rules update and the first in a series of intended chronicle books that would give a default focus for games and update their rules to work with the new rules released in the God Machine Chronicle. The system changes include the addition of conditions and tilts, which are usually temporary traits that can impact characters' abilities, while conditions apply at all times. Tilts usually directly affect combat. The experience point system also changed greatly. Throughout a session, players now accumulate beats through coping with or resolving conditions, dealing with hardships, or accomplishing goals. When the player accumulates 5 beats, she may redeem these for an experience improving character traits is now flat, such that buying the first dot of a trait costs the same as purchasing the final dot of the same. On August 16, 2014, Onyx Path Publishing revealed that they were publishing a second edition of the World of Darkness setting, using the God Machine rules. They also announced that they would be releasing new editions of their first 5 games in the setting. While Vampire: The Requiem had released its Strix Chronicles less than a year previous, Onyx Path conceded that the second edition of Requiem would be identical enough to Strix that they would supply a free PDF of the second edition to anyone who had already purchased a PDF copy of that book. Book's New World of Darkness and WOD World of Darkness Rulebook. August 2004 WW55002 Second Sight. April 2006 WW55100 Armory. January 2006 WW55102 Chicago. December 2005 WW55200 Antagonists. December 2004 WW55301 Mysterious Places. June 2005 WW55302 Ghost Stories. November 2004 WW55400 Storytellers Screen. WW55701 Shadows of the UK. June 2006 WW30202 Skinchangers. July 2006 WW30305 Tales from the 13th Precinct. July 2006 WW55001 Shadows of Mexico. October 2006 WW25201 Urban Legends. April 2007 WW55303 Book of Spirits. May 2007 WW55202 Asylum. August 2007 WW55204 Reliquary. September 2007 WW55203 Changing Breeds. October 2007 WW55103 Midnight Roads. February 2008 WW55205 Innocence. April 2008 WW55004 God Machine Chronicles. April 2013 References. Carrot A.B. Appleklein, Shannon. 1 February 2007 A Brief History of Game Number 11, White Wolf, Part 1, 1986-1995, RPG Net. Skotos Tech Inc. Retrieved 16 September 2007. Carrot Dansky, Richard. 1996 Wraith, The Oblivion. White Wolf, Inc. ISBN. Carrot Appleklein, Shannon. 7 February 2007 A Brief History of Game Number 12, White Wolf, Part 2, 1993 Present. RPG Net. Skotos Tech Inc. Retrieved 16 September 2007. EABA Fate Fudge Fusion Gumshoe GURPS Harp Hero Interlock Masterbook Meg's Megaversal Palladium Omni 1 Roll Engine Powered by the Apocalypse QAGSR PC 54 Rhesus Rollmaster Saga Savage Worlds SFSRS Storyteller, Storytelling Traveler TriStat True 20 Twerps Ubiquity Unisystem